William J. Dub Waldrip of Lubbock, Texas, has built an outstanding national reputation. Through a combination of formal education and practical experience, he has excelled in an industry that demands endless energy, abundant knowledge, and a great reservoir of leadership skills. Today, he serves as the president and chief executive officer of the famous Spade Ranches, headquartered in Lubbock. This historic spread began with the purchase of the Rinderbrook in 1889 by one of two inventors of barbed wire, Colonel Isaac Elwood of Illinois. This famous brand came with the original herd. Over the years, this ranch has grown until today its cattle graze some 350,000 acres through seven West Texas and three New Mexico counties. Present owners are Mr. Frank Chappell, the great-grandson of founder Isaac Elwood, and his sister, Mrs. Marion Bassam. Dub Waldrip's career with the Spades began in 1967 when he was hired as the ranch manager. He immediately began a search for a three- or four-breed rotational crossbreeding program. He insisted that the strains never contain more than 9/16% of any breed in the cross of Hereford, Brown Swiss, Angus, and Simmental. During this period, Simmental were so rare outside their native Switzerland that Waldrip and the Spades were forced to create their own, using embryo transplants and imports. Dub was once asked, "What color are your Swiss cross calves?" He smiled and replied, "In the end, mostly green." This innovator strives for a cow that is a good mother, has some longevity, produces a good calf, and takes care of herself. His love for the land and the native grasses guide many of his decisions. The range is your resource. If you don't have sustainability, then it doesn't matter what kind of cattle you have. You can't afford to mistreat this old fragile country. And today, this great ranch is one of the largest cow-calf operations in the United States. When it comes to drought conditions, this dedicated caretaker of the land believes in the old saying, "Let your country tell you when to move cattle. If you wait for your cattle to tell you, it's too late." This American patriot served with the U.S. Army Air Corps as a four-engine bomber pilot, including B-17s and B-29s, from April 1943 to December 1945. Dub was among the first to graduate from Texas A&M University's Range Department. He has earned three college degrees from that university, including a doctorate in range science. From 1950 to 1958, he held a joint teaching research position in the range department at Texas A&M. Then in 1958, he left the campus environment and took the reins of the new Texas Experimental Ranch near Throckmorton. Let's let Dub tell us about it.
The severe drought of the 50s aroused a lot of interest in range research in the ranching industry in West Texas because a lot of folks thought they were going broke. So under a three-part agreement, Texas A&M provided the research. The Great Swenson Land and Cattle Company provided the land and the livestock. And ranchers all over West Texas contributed to the building of fences and tanks, and pens, and the barn and house. All the improvements were paid for by contributions. We were mostly interested in range livestock nutrition and grazing systems, and so were the folks that were in the livestock business.
His knowledge and love of agriculture earned him leadership positions with varied organizations throughout the United States. He served as president of the Texas Simmental Association, a director of the Society of Range Management, and was an advisory board member of the New Mexico Stock Growers Association. He served as a member of several USDA advisory boards, the Dean's Advisory Committee at Texas Tech University, the Administrator's Advisory Committee, U.S. Environmental Protection Agency, and is a director of the Chicago Mercantile Exchange. He has also served as a director of the Texas and Southwestern Cattle Raisers Association for more than 25 years and is a past director of the Texas Cattle Feeders Association. His leadership contributions also include the Texas Experimental Ranch Advisory Committee and the Brush Control and Range Improvement Association. He is so concerned that we must preserve our livestock heritage that he has served for many years as a director of the Ranching Heritage Center. In 1983, he was elected president of the National Cattlemen's Association, which today is known as the National Cattlemen's Beef Association. It was during his service with this prestigious organization that he initiated a program to reach consumers by educating the major food editors in the United States. Here's Dub to tell us about it.
We needed to improve our image, the image of the beef industry, and we didn't have any money. We decided to get representatives from all major publications out in the country. We took them out in the ranch country. Most of them were from Manhattan and hadn't been out there before, so they really enjoyed it. But I think for the money spent, the industry probably got as much mileage from that investment as anything we've ever done.
His tireless dedication to one of the greatest industries in the world has brought him many honors and much recognition. In 1977, he received the Gerald W. Thomas Award as Outstanding Agriculturalist from Texas Tech University. He was honored as the Outstanding Rangeman of the Year by the Texas Section of Range Management in 1967 and acclaimed as a Fellow in 1984. In 1995, the International Society of Range Management presented him with their Lifetime Achievement Award. The citation announced, in part, Dr. William J. Dub Waldrip is a living, working example of almost every aspect of the art and science of range management. He personally has worked as a staunch advocate of rangeland in most states, many congressional and agency offices, and up to the President of the United States and his advisors. Dub Waldrip's leadership and boundless energy have been called upon many times within his local community, state, and nation. This included directorships in the Tongue River Corporation and the American State Bank of Lubbock. In 1994, through his efforts, the Spades received the Regional 1994 Environmental Stewardship Award, which recognized outstanding conservation achievements made by today's cattle families. He was born November 7, 1924, in Wichita Falls, Texas. This loving husband and his wife, Emily, have five children, Cynthia, Mark, Julie, Matthew, and Donald. Dub Umbley recalls his road to success.
I couldn't work for better folks than the ones who gave me the opportunity, and then turned it over to me, scared me to death, but they gave me a free hand. Oh, I think it's a combination of hard work and a lot of good luck. My parents taught me to work, and I guess the good Lord gave me the luck.
It is with great pride that we present the 1996 Golden Spur Award to Dub Waldrip, this nation's top rancher.